Today I will try to speak about the first wave of black metal. And when we speak about the first wave of black metal, first of all we have to understand that this is not the black metal in the meaning that we know it today. The black metal, the genre of the black metal, how we know it today, especially built by the second wave of black metal, especially from Norway, and of course also afterwards from Sweden, from Finland, Scandinavian black metal, from Greece, and from other places. So, before that I will start. What we're listening, if we're listening, is one special album of alternative rock, post-rock, country post-rock of Woven Hand and their album Consider the Birds. Special album. Also in Woven Hand, in their works, they have also Christian lyrics. And also, if I speak about Woven Hand, I have to speak about this famous work, my favorite Woven Hand album, Refractory Obtude. Okay, and now I'm continue with the first wave of black metal. First of all, I had also to speak about bands as Von and or Tormentor from Hungary, the band of Attila before he became the singer of Mayhem. So let's start. First of all, let's speak about Venom from England. Venom, they started inside the what we call it new wave of British heavy metal, but they were even more extreme. They brought the so-called Satanism inside metal, even more strong than Black Sabbath before them, or than Coven, a band of occult blues rock from United States. Venom and their first album of them, Welcome to Hell. But not only the first album, also the second album, some people will put also the third album. Their second album of Venom, Black Metal. Also the name of this album gave the name to the whole scene of black metal. But of course, Venom, they continue, they are the children of Motorhead. But also Venom, they had their children, Sodom, from Germany. And yes, the first works of the great three unholy trinity of Germanic, Teutonian thrash metal, they were a big influence to the first wave of black metal. So first of all, we have to speak about Sodom and their first works in the sign of evil and also obsessed by cruelty. But not only Sodom, also Creator in their first album, Endless Pain. Here also we can listen things that they are influences to the first wave of black metal. For example, Rotting Christ from Greece, they made the covers in the songs Tormentor and in the song Flag of Hate. Destruction also with their first EP, Sentence of Death. But not only the unholy trinity of German thrash metal. Let's speak also about Holy Moses and their first work, and their first album, the debut album Queen of Siam, with their woman, female singer, Sabina Clansen, okay? And here they play as Venom in this album. The influences of Venom, they are here. And not only Holy Moses, let's speak also about Necronomicon from Germany, another extreme thrash metal band from Germany, their second album, Apocalyptic Nightmare. For me, this album also has its influences to the first wave of black metal. And if we speak about the German thrash metal scene, let's speak about another scene of thrash metal that was also very important for the first wave of black metal. And I'm speaking about the Brazilian thrash metal scene. We have also, first of all, bands as Sarcofago with their first album INRI, and we have also Vulcano from Brazil and their first work Blandy Vincents, and also Mystifier from Brazil and their album Goetia, also a big influence to the first wave of in black metal. And even we can here speak about the first works of Sepultura, for example, Morbid Visions. Another also band from Canada that took the influences from Sarcofago from Brazil and some of the influences of Bathory from Finland, and they made another subgenre by themselves, the so-called raw black metal or bestial black metal or war metal. And they speak about Blasphemy from Canada and their first work Fallen Angel of Doom, a great, great album. Also here they have influences of grind, of death grind inside their music. But also we can say that they are between the first wave and the second wave of black. And now let's go to another important band, Celtic Frost, or Celtic Frost, call it how you want, from Switzerland. The Celtic Frost, and before Celtic Frost we had another band, Hellhammer. Okay, Celtic Frost, they came from Hellhammer, and Hellhammer also, they were a big influence to death metal but also to the black metal. Even the Fischer warrior Gabriel Fischer does like it so much. And they will speak about Hellhammer. First of all, let's speak about the historical EP of them, Apocalyptica Raids. Also, I have here with this cover, not with the historical classical cover, unfortunately. And about their demo, Satanic Rites, a great work. Also, some songs from here, they gave the names of the surnames of the members of Mayhem. For example, here we have Messiah, the song Messiah, Maniac, and Evrinomus. And if we spoke about Hellhammer, let's speak now about Celtic Frost. Also, they were influenced by Venom. They called it Venom is killing music, and Celtic Frost and Hellhammer, they're killing Venom. So their first EPs of them, of Celtic Frost, Morbid Tales, and Morbid Tales, and also Emperor's Return. But not only. There's a great also work of them, to Megatherion, a big influence to the first wave of black metal. And if we speak about Celtic Frost, we have to remember that they also put corpse paint, even before the corpse paint became so important to the black metal because of Dead, because of the singer of Mayhem Dead. Also we can see here that Thomas Gabriel Warrior Fischer and Martin Erring Ein, rest in peace, they put corpse paint. The whole story of corpse paint starts with Arthur Brown, a sock rocker of 60s, 70s, afterwards with Alice Cooper, afterwards with Kiss, and afterwards with King Diamond of Merciful Fate. A little bit also Death SS from Italy, and afterwards Celtic Frost, and of course afterwards Dead from Morbid and from Mayhem, and the whole black metal scene of Norway, and not only, took it, the corpse paint, to themselves. Okay, and now another big influence to the first wave of black metal, Merciful Fate of King Diamond. Not for the music, because Merciful Fate, they play a style of power heavy metal with very extreme vocals of King Diamond, but stylistic, and they gave a big influence to the first wave of black metal. Here I will bring the two first works of them, the debut album Melissa, and of course their second album, the great album Don't Break the Oath. And now let's go to the most important band between the first wave and the second wave of black metal from Sweden, and speak about Bathory. Bathory with the first work, Bathory. Here also we have big influences from Venom. This is also one of the big influences to the black thrash scene. But also their second album, The Return. And not only, their third album maybe is the first pure black metal album of all the years. And I'm speaking about the album Under the Sign of the Black Mark. But together with this, I will put also their fourth work, Blood, Fire, Death, because this is also very a big influence to the Viking black metal, or to epic black metal, or to pagan black metal, call it how you want. And now, another band from Sweden, I spoke about it before, Morbid. The band Morbid was the band of the singer Dead before that became the singer of Mayhem. And here we have their first EP, demo, okay, December Moon. Also, this we have this album with many covers. A great album of extreme thrash, extreme death of these years, and first wave of black metal. And now let's go to the bands that they started the second wave of black metal, especially from Norway. And especially we speak about Mayhem, Burzum, Darkthrone, Satyricon, Emperor, and Immortal, okay? But for me, the most important bands were Mayhem, Darkthrone, and Burzum. So let's go and speak about Mayhem and their first EP, Death Cross. Yes, in this EP they don't play the black metal how we know it. Also here we have many influences from punk. But it's a very, very important work between the first and second wave of black metal. And let's speak about their debut album, The Mysteries Dom Satanas. This is one of the first albums of the second wave, of the classical second wave of black metal. And another also very important album that started the second wave of Norwegian black metal, and maybe it came out first, and speaking about the second album of Darkthrone, A Blaze in the Northern Sky. In the first album they played even more death metal, and afterwards they made a difference. And another also work of 1992, the first work of Burzum, the first album, debut album of Burzum, of Varg, of course, and his first EP, Asker. For me, this was also the albums that they were between the first and the second wave of black metal. So, this is about the most important works for me. Especially about the first wave of black metal. So from Israel and from Jerusalem, stay metal and stay heavy.